Using Step Sequencer and Arpeggiator MIDI plugins help us to create slick and sometimes wild patterns. In the latest N-Track release, we've included a Step Sequencer MIDI plugin and Arpeggiator to help you spark creative ideas with synths and MIDI instruments. You can access both in the latest version of N-Track Studio on iOS, Android, Windows and Mac. Simply update the N-Track Studio app in App Store or Google Play, or download to the latest desktop version from ntrack.com. In this video, we'll be using N-Track Studio for iOS. An arpeggiator is a plugin that creates an arpeggio from the chord that you play on the keyboard, alternating between the notes pressed and following a movement, like up or down. Think of how a harp player moves their hands gently across the strings, picking notes of a chord in a certain repeating sequence. A step sequencer effect, on the other hand, typically works with a single note played on the keyboard. It creates a quick melody or sequence of notes transposed relative to the note played on the keyboard. The sequence can be very fast, so you may not catch every single note, but the overall effect is to create a different sound than would be heard if just each single note is playing. N-Track also has step sequencer tracks, which are a completely different thing. There's a link above for more information on that, and it has its own video. The arpeggiator and sequencer MIDI effects in N-Track are actually part of the same plugin that can operate in one of the two modes. To get to the arpeggiator and sequencer, let's add an instrument track. We'll then open the sampler using the keyboard icon and click the arpeggiator button. We're prompted to select arpeggio. Let's choose Coins, a step sequencer preset. To get started, press and hold a keyboard note. We hear the pattern that plays and repeats based on the current sequence. The active steps are shown in green with their note intervals in the lower grey box. Let's switch to a different preset, fifths, for example. We can hear how this sequencer preset sounds by switching to a synth sound. We'll open the instrument browser and select Detuned Saw. Let's tap to deselect a couple of the sequence steps. We can see that these change from green to grey as they're switched off. We can press and hold a note and hear that the sequence pattern has changed. We can also press and hold multiple keyboard notes at the same time. There's an interval row below the sequence row. By clicking on an interval box, we can set the interval. The interval is the number of semitones above or below the note that we play on the screen keyboard. For example, if we click on step one and change the interval to 12 semitones, we can hear that the first note of our sequence jumps up an octave from the note we're holding. We can actually see both the interval and semitone value when customizing the interval row. By default, the subdivision menu is set at 1 over 16. Let's click and drag our subdivision menu to 1 over 8. 1/8 means that each sequence step is equal to 1/8 note or 1 over 8. The full row of 8 eighth notes equals 8 over 8, which equates to a full 4/4 bar. It's worth noting that a sequence step always counts as a subdivision, whether it's selected in green or deselected in grey. If we deselect step 2, for example, we hear that the step still plays as a silent note. Using this is important to be able to create interesting rhythmic patterns with the sequencer. And to those of you who want to do some experimentation, there are loads of subdivisions to mix this up with, including triplets and even quintuplets. Returning to our original 1 over 16 subdivision value, we can hear that the sequence pattern of 8 steps plays twice as quickly as when the subdivision value was set at 1 over 8. This is logical because where a step was previously equal to an 8th note, now it equals a 16th note, and so plays at double the speed. So to get our full bar of 4/4 time, we need to add a second row of 8 steps, which will give us 16 steps. Pressing and holding a note on the screen keyboard, we can now hear our sequence pattern extends to 16 steps. If you want to mix things up more, additional rows can be added by tapping the plus button again, and rows can be easily removed by tapping the minus button. We can use the swing knob to alter how swung our sequencer patterns sound. Let's hear a couple of examples. We can record and play back our ideas without leaving the sequencer. Simply click the red record button to start getting ideas down. If you make a mistake and want to retry recording, stop, tap the undo button, and press record again. One recommendation would be to enable the metronome and set one bar of pre-roll when recording so that you can record in time and know where you are. To do this, we'll go to the metronome icon and enable it. We'll then go to settings and turn pre-roll on. Here's how you do that. If you want to change the range of the screen keyboard, tap the keyboard range button in the side toolbar. When the range button is enabled, scroll the keyboard left or right to locate your desired range. We can also zoom in and out to view more or less notes at a time. Make sure to tap the button again to lock the selected range, otherwise the keyboard will move under our fingers as we're playing. Enabling the quantize button quantizes the notes you play according to the song's tempo and the subdivision set in the plugin. Note that the first note you press is always played immediately. Using the available presets can be viewed as a great way to get started quickly with the sequencer. We'd recommend trying them out and then tweaking and modifying the settings already discussed to taste. Let's switch to the arpeggiator using the tab on the plugin. We can see controls now familiar to us: subdivision, swing, quantize, and the step editor. The main new control is mode. In the sequencer, when more than one note is played, both notes simultaneously play the same step sequence in parallel with one another, so we can hear more than one note at the same time. With the arpeggiator, when more than one note is played at the same time, we still only ever hear one note at a time. So if we play three notes with the go-up mode selected, we can hear that the notes play one at a time from low to high with the chosen subdivision and swing values that are set. Let's change the instrument to hear how the arpeggiator sounds using a classical guitar sound. Let's enable the step editor and hear how the same notes play low to high, the go-up mode with the rhythm shown in green and grey. Changing the mode to go down, we can hear the direction of the notes change from high to low. You can choose from various mode settings, which, when combined with the other available tools, leave you with a huge pool of combinations to create from. Let's hear another example using the random mode. The sequencer and arpeggiator are great ways of inspiring riffs, melodies, and song ideas. Let us know if any questions or comments come up when trying them out. And as ever, if you could please give this video a like, subscribe so we can keep this channel growing, and ding that notification bell so you know when our next video is out, that would be great. Until then, have fun making music with NTrack. Cheers.